When we last spoke during the press tour of Romeo and Juliet, you had told me you'd gone method and spent about 3 months standing by a pond with a fishing rod. Did that experience help you in any way with salmon fishing in the Yemen?
Yes, I lived amongst salmon for this.
Swimming,
and then I ate them as well, which was weird, but I had to have the whole scope of the experience. I didn't have to fish really in this movie, so I just had to look like I knew what I was doing when speaking Mandarin. And that was about it. So I only know how to talk about salmon fishing in Mandarin. That's literally all I know how to talk about.
Was it a problem that you don't actually like salmon?
No. But yet the only problem is that every press junket or every, you know, dinner we've had, they'll serve salmon, you know, with a kind of wink and a nudge. And you're like, yeah. Good one. I totally get it. It's about salmon fishing.
I was going to ask you, you've done plenty of press for this before. Is there one particular question that keeps getting asked along those lines?
How do you like your salmon cooked, and do you like fishing?
In the film, Ewan draws a great picture of a giant bucket, a fish on a gravestone, a shake fishing, and a running tap.
Yes.
Was there a fight over who got to keep it?
There wasn't, actually. I think he should have fought to keep that. He didn't draw the whole thing, though. I know I'm telling you something that's upsetting, but we had a fantastic artist who would just draw it and he'd finish off the tap or something like that.
It's the magic of movies, ruined.
He didn't draw that shake. That shake was brilliant. Brilliant stuff.
I'll have to put a warning on this video.
Yeah, contains spoilers. Not drawn by Ewan McGregor.
Your character spends a lot of the first half of the film saying the words, Dr. Jones.
Yes, Dr. Jones.
Did you ever get at any point Aqua's 90s hit, Dr. Jones, stuck in your
head? Oh my God, I hate that song so much. I hate that song with such a passion.
Because of you, I left the cinema with that in my head.
You didn't. Oh God, now that's all I'm going to think about.
Do you think that this film is the closest thing we'll ever get to a fishing bureaucracy-themed Indiana Jones movie?
I don't know if there's any other movie that could be that. So I'll say yes. It's at least original.
Right. From what I read in the production notes, this is going to be even surreal than the previous question. Your parents essentially nagged you into taking this role on pain of a distinct huff. Is this true?
A distinct huff. Oh God, I love the way Brits phrase stuff. It's heaven to be around. They were definitely quite keen on the thought of me doing it. I had already signed on.
Ah.
So I don't do what my mum tells me at this age anyway. But I was already very into the idea of doing it, and they love the book. They are seeing the movie for the second time tonight. I have offered them dinner with their long-lost daughter who lives in the States, but they are going to go and see the movie instead.
That's
rude.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, I mean, were you disappointed that you didn't actually get to go to Yemen during the shoot?
Not really, because I think that it's not exactly appealing to go to a country that is on the brink of civil war.
Yeah.
So, and it's, I think Morocco was definitely the easier bet for all of us, and it was a beautiful experience being there.
And I asked you this beforehand in the previous interview, whether you could, impersonate anybody else in the cast. How good is your Ewan impression?
Terrible. I don't know how to do Ewan. I don't know how to do it.
Not even Obi-Wan Ewan?
I think a phrase Ewan says a lot, which I definitely have used now. He always says, yeah, it's nice, it's lovely. Oh, it's lovely, yeah, it's nice. He always says things like that.